Hi there. In this video, you will learn how consumer practices have developed in co-evolution with the provision of urban infrastructure in Europe, and how they still do. I will also address the changes in water and energy infrastructure from the perspective of end-user practices. If we see urban infrastructures only from an engineering's point of view, we get something like this. And in these pictures, consumers, the users of water, are invisible. Water consumption is pictured just as a house. The good thing about this picture is that at least different purposes of water consumption are shown. Bathing, doing the laundry, toilet use. The same story goes for energy. The secondary customer here in this picture, that's the householder, using electricity for diverse practices like watching TV, heating the home by running a heat pump, lighting, doing the dishes, keeping the Christmas turkey frozen. All these practices are heavily depending on the availability of materials, such as a reliable and continuous supply of electricity and water, and on the devices that run on them, toilets, TV sets, freezers and showers. But these practices are also pillared by meanings, such as cultural beliefs and taboos, personal preferences, privacy considerations. And lastly, by competences, how to use things, how to cook, how to clean yourself or your house. So let's have a look at one example, the practice of bathing. It has changed considerably over time, and so did urban infrastructures for water and energy supply. One could say that infrastructure provision was the driver for changing bathing practices from the public domain, like here, to the private bathroom. But there was also another driver of change. Our attitude towards sweat, from appreciation, as in honest labor, towards disgust. Norms of cleanliness have changed considerably over time. In the past, we did all the cleaning with one bar of soap. Now, we use a range of shampoos and shower gels. From a bath once in the 2 weeks or so, we now sometimes take a shower twice a day. And the bath at home has moved from the kitchen to its own room. All these changes in water and energy supply and consumption are social and technical at the same time. Technology is indeed a driver, but also cultural norms and competences of householders. They co-evolve at the same time. This is why we should also investigate the social-cultural dynamics of water and energy-related practices alongside the sustainable development of water and energy infrastructure. For instance, the smart grid. This is mostly seen as an efficient electricity distribution system that facilitates renewable energy generation and storage. So far, the smart grid descriptions and visualizations are mostly technical of nature. But with the smart grids come smart meters with close to real-time data generation about household electricity consumption and production. And with smart grids come intermittent supply of electricity, depending on the contract consumers have with their suppliers. Issues of privacy protection come to the fore, and the timing of use of electricity is becoming negotiable. Consumers will be asked to allow their electric cars to store electricity at certain prescribed moments for the sake of net balance of the entire system. These are big changes from a 100-year-old routine of electricity consumption. New energy practices are emerging alongside the development of smart grids. Studying sustainable urban energy supply would better take these socio-technical dynamics into account. Because if you don't, you may overlook possible reasons for resistance towards new technologies. If you would define household energy consumptions in terms of kilowatt hours only, you will miss differences in practices that explain the adoption or resistance to innovations like this smart meter. For some practices, shifting time of use would be just fine. Think of a dishwasher switching on in the night instead of in the evening. No problem. But it surely matters in other practices, like cooking, which is, of course, highly time-bound. Now, I would like you to challenge you to think of other socio-technical changes that co-evolve with social practices.